New job, new IT department, new Elitedesk. Hello and welcome back to Simple Silicon. I'm Dan, your host for today. We've got a new Elitedesk, HP Elitedesk 705 G4. This is quite a few years later, 2020. The first video that I did on an Elitedesk was in 2016. So there's been a few upgrades since then, mostly in the processor and the graphical capabilities. Going over the front, we have a USB Type-C, USB Type-A, got two of those, headphone in and microphone in and out. I believe that they can be either or in software. On the back side, this is two display ports, four Type-A ports, and this particular part can be interchanged when you order at the factory. This is a serial port, but there are VGAs and another display port. You just get a whole bunch. And networking gigabit there with the Kensington lock above it. And then, of course, we got power. This little doohickey here is the Wi-Fi antenna that protrudes from the case. On the back, we have what appears to be a vase mount. It seems to be the right dimensions. Anyway, let's get into taking this thing apart and hooking up to the bench. So I had to refilm this intro, so be prepared that everything after this is like 2 months ago, and I was a bit sick then, so I do apologize, but all the information is still relevant here in March as it was when I filmed this back in January. All right, take a look. All right, we're turning the device on for the first time. It's your standard HP logo there. We'll probably skip through right to when the Windows startup and the benchmarks. We're presented with the standard Windows setup screen. We're just going to re-image it, but for right now, I'll just go through this so we can run some benchmarks. In case you were not going to re-image it or reinstall Windows, kind of the stuff that comes with it, but you get your basic HP stuff, warranty and stuff. You can close out of that. The HP, Assistant, does that come with it? The HP Support Assistant is a great place. It'll have you go through some questions here. And you can just hit next, cancel that. Basically, it tells you just everything about your device. So the model number here is kind of more clear. It's the HP Elitedesk 705 G4 DM35W in parentheses TAA. Windows 10 Pro or whatever. Anyway, this is a great place to get all the updates for the drivers and stuff. So even if you image your computer afterwards, you're going to get the ability to do all these updates and firmware updates as well. I'm surprised. It depends on how long it's been on the shelf. But like I said, they know their own stuff. Before we begin, I just want to point out that our CPU is the AMD Ryzen 5 Pro 2400GE with Radeon Vega graphics. That's a 4-core, 8-thread processor at 3.2 gigahertz. It will speed down, but we'll get some temperature benchmarks here while we do our tests. So here we are running Cinebench R15. Let's give it a go. So Cinebench R15 multi-core run gives us a 728. That's between the 4770K and the i7-3770 CPU. That's, you know, pretty good for an office computer. The Elitedesk here does have an speaker built into it, but it's not quite so clear. So let us play a little sample for what we're talking about, and I will zoom out a little bit. So I'm going to put the mic up here and we can listen.
Dill can be a good old-fashioned mechanical hard drive if you need lots of storage space.
So it's a bit tinny. It's pretty on par for their speakers in the past. So let's bump this up to 4K and see how it does. All right, that playback seems fairly decent. There's no stuttering. If we look at the CPU usage, we're sitting around 2 to 6%, 4%, so it's pretty reasonable. Okay, so what I have up on the screen is Passmark, just like the original video, except this is their newer version. I'm going to try and just get some comparisons as well, so the numbers actually mean anything. But I'll let this run and you can take a look. All right, so we have a Passmark score of 3,123.8. I'll have to get some comparisons with this version number. That's the 9.0 evaluation. The CPU mark specifically was 8,125.3. 2D graphics mark is 664.2. 3D graphics mark is 1,371.3. Memory mark is 1,422.8. Disk mark is 4,689.6. And we can just hit OK there. The usage of this computer, I think, for our use case in school, that will be used by directors and administrators, secretaries, and so forth. Also works great as a school computer for library purposes. It's just an all-around good performer for that, better than bare bones that you might get in some other lower-end models, especially with that high, that four-core eight-thread, which was normally an i7 territory, just 3 years ago, but now, with AMD coming out strong with the Ryzen series, it's a great performer. Level 1 cache, 384 kilobits, level 2, 2 megs, level 3, 4 megs. So we're looking at something, like I said, that performs pretty good all around. 4K videos, good productivity, no matter what you want to do with it. So, do I recommend it? I mean, it's a computer. I mean, it's based on use case. So if you have a need for something that performs well like this, that can do most secretary things that you ever need it to do. So just as a little side note, I was checking the additional models that we got in, just to see if there was any variation and checking serials and stuff. And there wasn't any difference with the model number, but we did get three different variants here. For instance, this is the one I showed you guys. It has VGA. But then there are other ones that just have an additional display port, if that's going to focus for you. And then there's a bunch that have serial ports. So, check on the website. I wasn't the one who ordered them, so I didn't see any difference in the model numbers, the stickers in the back that could reference why that difference is there. There's a good chance these were just refurb models because they're cheaper to get. But they're $500, by the way, so that's pretty cheap. So just keep that in mind, that there are some options that can be swapped out. So opening the device is quite straightforward. We have a screw on the back and the bottom, so the front slides forward. And then we just lift off like this. And we can see the internals here. What we've got, our fan covering. It looks like the CPU-GPU combo. We have our SSD. So it should be pretty serviceable to change. It's very compact, as you can see. Dusting it out would be simply taking some compressed air and cleaning it out here. Feeling this, and looking in here, it looks like this entire piece is metal, with the fin, so it feels like you get this whole area for cooling. But it isn't, still isn't that much. We saw Cinebench R15, I was hitting those high temps of 74, which might be its thermal TJ max. I have to look that up for that CPU, but yeah. So adapter cards for the VGA cable down there. PC speaker right here. That's the audio test that I showed you. I don't see the Wi-Fi card potential. RAM underneath the cooler, if you see right in there. So you'd have to, oh, that just lifts up. Okay. I'm doing this with you guys. So that lifts right up. You have another slot that you can add RAM to. It seems like it's a toolless design, so you get an airflow over the RAM at least. USB type C. Get a little button right here. I'm not sure if that's, that might be a CMOS clear switch. So CMOS is CMOS right here. I think this little button at the end is a CMOS. On first inspection, you'd have to look it up. But, I don't know if there is a wireless card in here though. I may have just misspoke. I just may have just assumed. Oh, look at this. Right underneath here, underneath this SSD, I don't know how well it comes on video, but there is a M.2 slot down there. I don't see this thing lifting up as easily. Yeah, you're going to have to unscrew it, but that's definitely an M.2 slot down there. And that's not the SATA version, that's NVMe, because I can tell by the, that the only, there's a, only the one notch is missing, whereas the SATA version of this form factor will have two notches missing, but this only has the one, so that's actual M.2. The battery is underneath here. I can, right down in there, there's the battery, so if you have to pull out the battery. Okay, so I did, I removed the two screws. This mechanism took me just a moment, but you slide it forward physically, and then you can just lift it right out. It, like I said, it likes to catch on this side right here. You can see that slide mechanism. Okay. So I was right, there was something else here, and I found the wireless card. It's a, an Intel model 9260NGW, whatever, you'd have to look that up. I might put that in later. M.2 slot accessible right there. I'm back. The camera I was using ran out of battery, so. Okay, so the last point I was making before the batteries ran out was that you have this whole length for a standard M.2 size. If you wish to. I don't know if that eats up a SATA slot. If I pull this out and show you the best that I can, this looks like it is a genuine actual socket. And I can tell because I don't know how well I can see in camera, but if you see, you see the retention pin there? If I had to make an educated guess, I would argue that it's a full-size socket, so you could change out the CPU if you had to. Which is cool, you know, because then it gives this thing a bit more life, for as long as the AM4 socket is still around. But yeah, so all in all, this is a nice little compact design. I kind of actually like it. The Wi-Fi is nice. The extra M.2 is nice for expansion. You may even just be able to put an M.2 here as the boot drive if you wanted to. I don't know. I don't have an M.2 to test to see if you can boot from it, but with modern technology, I don't think there would be any reason why you wouldn't be able to. So in conclusion, I recommend this for use as a school computer, secretary's computer. It might be a bit overpowered for that. Any conference room computer, because we tested the 4K playback from YouTube, seemed to work just fine. Again, definitely do 1080p, no problem.
Word processing, definitely more than you'd need for that. So this is kind of like productivity with two monitors, Word on one side, email client on the other, YouTube on one side for lunch break, emails on the other, calendar and stuff like that. $500, all around pretty good. I just wanted to point out some stuff I didn't cover. Lightning bolt on this USB cable right there, so fast charging, that's nice. People can charge their phones and so forth. On the back, there is no other lightning bolt at all. The only lightning bolt on the front. But you do have super speed on the back for the rest of it. It's all USB 3. And I don't know what gen it is. I didn't really get to see too easily, but I imagine it's USB 3.0, Gen 1, whatever. The 5 gigabits variety. I doubt that they would have the full 10 gigabits. I know the USB 3, in case you were wondering, because I can see the pin layout. You have the extra 5 pins in the back. Same thing for the USB Type-C. It might just be just your standard 3.0. Headphones on the front there. They do have a mic input. So this one on the right has the mic icon underneath the headset. So if people need to be able to hook up a microphone to do meetings over Skype or Teams or whatever, that'll work just fine. Like I said, some of the models, this particular one has VGA. They all have dual display port. They can come with serial on some of the models, and just an extra display port on the other, so for three. So just depending on what one you get, you can expect something different. They all have the same IO otherwise. That back piece is the only interchangeable. Maybe it's interchangeable for us, but that's not really something that they probably sell you independently. All comes with Windows 10. Right now, it's 2020. They're coming with Windows 10. On the back, I think that's a base amount. Probably. Thank you for watching this episode of Simple Silicon. Hit that thumbs up button, get subscribed, hit the bell icon if you want to be notified instantly every time I upload. Leave a comment down below if your opinions are more complicated than thumbs up and thumbs down. So we'd love to hear from you. So thank you very much for watching. I'm Dan, your host, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye for now. Enjoy.